cementing its place on Brighton's seafront as hundreds of tons of concrete are poured into what will be the future home to the tallest observation tower outside of London. It's the latest milestone in the i360's construction process, with 200 lorry loads of foundations travelling in from sites at Shoreham, Burgess Hill and Chichester.
It's the first of our large volume concrete pours today, so we're going to pour about 1,200 cubic metres of concrete today. We started at 6 a.m. this morning with the first load in, and things so far so good. The thing is with the concrete pours are that once you start them, you've got to finish it. You have no other choice. From an engineering perspective, we can't allow any cold joints to form in the concrete while it's curing. So yes, so far so good.
With TV characters on hand, there's a lot of excitement from the public.
I think it's a good attraction for Brighton, bring money to the town, people, support these shops, I think it'll be good.
I'd be scared, but I'd go on it.
I'm more scared when you're at the bottom looking up than when you're at the top looking down.
The process is the culmination of months of planning.
Yes, today's the culmination of nearly 6 months' worth of planning. Again, it's really important because we only get one shot at this. We've got to make sure everything's right, so we need to make sure that we've covered every eventuality.
You know, we've got the Hollandia team in Holland, we've got Poma in France, Mackley, who are the local Sussex ground workers. So, you know, there's lots of people involved, and I've been brought in to try and coordinate everyone. And it's going well. We're a good team, and we're looking forward to progressing it even further.
I'm really excited now the tower's due from Rotterdam, and all of a sudden things will be on the up, so to speak.
There will be a further 3 days of concrete laying next week to make way for the arrival of steel cans, which will form the viewing tower. With the liftoff for the i360 in summer next year, it's not long until the tourist attraction will be taken off. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.